cried for love, but not for you.
Poor boy Seaman.
I cried for love, but not for you.
And there's a senior discount.
Oh, screw the discount.
Dorothy, that's your ego talking. Before I was a senior, if they asked me, I said yes. 10% is 10%.
Well, I'm insulted if they ask.
You're way past the age
of... Not way past.
I'm sorry. Dorothy, you have arrived. You are of an age.
Piss off.
You're being delusional. Delulu, as the kids say. Avoiding the obvious.
Well, I'm not avoiding it. I just prefer to ignore it.
Isn't that kind of the same thing?
Oh, for Christ's sake, I know.
Right.
I feel as if I'm forgetting something. Is it something that we're supposed to do?
Spooky. I was going to say the same thing.
Oh my God. Hello, everybody.
Hi, everybody. Okay, well.
Follow us,
yeah,
why don't you?
Come right this way, please.
We are now on Lower Gockle, and we are approaching Upper Gockle. Felt good, did my face in case I ran into David, thinking I had a spring in my step, and then coming towards me was this really hot young guy, maybe 25. He looked so damn good. I smiled a bit seductively. He looks at me and he smiles back. Ooh. And I'm thinking, I still got it.
Oh, you go, girl.
And then I thought with a sudden surge of horror, he's not thinking hot woman. He's thinking friend of my mom.
Grandmother would be a little bad. I knew I had reached that age when I suddenly became invisible.
Yeah.
Remember when men would help with the groceries? Hold the door for you. Walk on the outside of the sidewalk.
Hit on you.
Yeah.
Yeah. 1 minute, you're tearing up the dance floor to Tainted Love, dressed like Madonna and desperately seeking Susan. And the next thing you know, you're emulating the Ascent of Man every morning.
The Ascent of Man?
Yeah, you know that picture that starts out with a monkey and ends up with an upright man?
You mean the March of Progress, originally titled The Road to Homo Sapien. It illustrates 25 million years of evolution.
Well, whatever the hell it's called, I do that every morning because, you know, lately I have to pee more and getting out of bed. My ankles aren't doing what they should be doing, not to mention my knees, which were only meant to last 40 years. So every morning, I get out of bed, and I start out like the monkey.
Technically ape.
Oh, have you any idea how annoying you are?
A bit, yeah.
So anyway, I start out like the ape, and by the time I reach the bathroom, I'm more like an upright Homo sapien. Modern man.
Yes.
That better? That okay?
Yes.
Oh my God. Yes! I have fallen out of love with my body. I'm not sure it was ever actually true love. More like an intermittent, fleeting infatuation. There was a very short period of time in my life when I loved my body. I cannot for the life of me remember exactly when that was, but probably no more than 2 weeks.
Women have an on-again, off-again relationships with their body. Mostly off. We're trained to hate our bodies.
Right.
I think too often about my first lover and I getting out of the bathtub and he said to me, "Your body would be perfect if you just lost a little weight here." He touched my thigh so there'd be no misunderstanding as to where my body was so imperfect.
Oh, ass.
Yeah. 45 years later, that moment still rolls around my brain like tumbleweed.
And yet the truth of the matter is, men are so damn happy you're gonna have sex with them. They don't care about any of that.
Not during, anyway.
Yeah.
When was the last time you know?
I can't remember. I don't know. 6, 7 years, maybe. I just don't want to subject any man to that. You know, my skin, it feels like it's decomposing while I'm wearing it, and my legs look like the salt flats of Nevada, and I just don't want anybody touching that and being repulsed. I couldn't take them recoiling from me.
Actually, the Bonneville salt flats are both in Nevada and Utah, straddling.
Yeah, right.
Never mind. I'm definitely past my best before date.
Oh.
Although my boobs are still pretty good.
Yeah, they're great.
Hitting 60 was not affirming. It was terrifying. Mm-hmm. And just putting on underpants is an accomplishment.
Underpants.
Oh, here we go.
Panties? Mm-hmm. Panties. Underpants. Not panties. Pantaloons. Not panties anymore.
I haven't gone to granny pants yet. Mm. But sometimes when I look down at the hole where my foot is supposed to go, it suddenly looks impossibly far away. I focus. I make sure I'm balanced. I lift my leg. I miraculously miss the hole, or worse, hit the crotch part and lose my balance and end up hopping around like a crazy person. Oh, man. Come on.
Walk this way.
Oh, stop.
I had a couple of wayward hairs on my chin. My aunt suggested a 10 times magnifying mirror. Don't do it. Your aunt may seem harmless, but I looked into that fisheye evil thing, ready to pluck my 3 wayward hairs, but realized with horror that I was sporting enough facial hair to perform in cats without makeup.
I gave up on those wayward hairs.
You know, there's a reason why our vision deteriorates as we get older. It's so we can't see any of that shit, neither can anyone else. A 10 times mirror is antithetical to the natural aging process. It's unnatural, but once you do it, there's no turning back.
Those young ones, the hipsters, Gen Xers, millennials, They have no idea how fast it goes.
That's right. The influencers with their filters and their padded bum underwear and their selfies and their gel bra inserts and the makeup that you need a trowel to remove and the painted eyebrows and the eyelashes. Oh my God, the eyelashes.
It's like two tarantulas died a horrible death on their faces.
And you know, the easiest way for girls to know if their men are cheating? The eyelashes. They find them in their beds, in their cars. Oh, and one idiot came home from a night out with the boys, and he undresses for bed, and he's got one stuck to his bum.
Oh, and don't forget the fingernails.
How can you possibly forget the fingernails? I can't sleep at night wondering how they wipe their ass.
I never thought of that. And I can't stop thinking about it.
I don't think I'll ever have a supernova, mind-blowing, incredible sex moment again.
I don't think I've ever had a supernova moment.
What? You mean you've never had a...
Nope.
Oh, why didn't you ever tell me that?
I didn't want you to think less of me.
Oh, come on. Let's go get a drink.
Good idea. Let's go for a drink.
Come on, let's go for a drink, everyone. So you can order drinks or order food or, you know, have a pee.
You know, despite all that,
yeah,
I still miss sex.
Oh, me too. But I'd only be willing to get naked with a man who's just come off a long-term relationship with an 87-year-old woman. Or man.
Oh, Dorothy.